Facebook is live. DLive is live. Waiting on Twitch and YouTube. Come on, buddy, you can do it. We believe in you. Ding, ding, ding. Yep, that's the Facebook notification. I'm waiting for the rest of you to get up and ready. It's weird that it's still streaming to Facebook. I thought I cancelled that because I unsubscribed from Restream. Well, who knows? Maybe I'll have you guys for another month. We'll see. We'll flip that coin. Just gonna pop a message on the Discord ever so quickly. Bear with me one sec, you fantastic people. Streamers live, streamers live. Uno Memento. HTTPS. Alright, I think we're good. So hello everyone, Jono here. Hope you're doing well. So, safe to say we've concluded our playthrough of Yu-Gi-Oh! Duels of the Roses. Hold on, things have been happening here, and nothing's working. Cheers for the follow. What's going on? Cheers for the follow, Hoss00312. Mate, really appreciate it. I only just started the stream, but appreciate the support nonetheless. Anyways, as I was saying, we finished Yu-Gi-Oh! Duelist of the Roses. What was it? No, that's not good. Why is that happening? Uh-oh. So how's your day going today, Jono? Well, this sums it up right now. It's because I've played this on the... Except the Euler again. It's because I've played this on the PlayStation 4. Yes. So anyways, had a bit of problems here. Let's just see if it was working now. Got some audio lag now, that's not good. Alright, it's Crash Bandicoot people. So, welcome to Insanity Beach. Gonna go do some quick audio tests. Wow, jinxed yourselves, why don't you? An Nexus and Jetpack? You're both lurking. What the hell? You can say hi if you want. Jokes. Alright, look, I'm gonna do a quick audio test because I believe that we got a bit of desync happening, so bear with me one second. We've got some shenanigans happening here. Alright, we have an audio loop. I know what the problem is. properties. Alright, I think it's fixed. Let's test, test, test. Alright, we're good. Apologies for that. Hello everyone, Jono here. Hope you're having a fantastic day. As mentioned, we finished our playthrough of Duelist of the Roses. So, what are we going to do now? Well, we're going to play some Crash Bandicoot. That was the next game that was tipped to be the favorite that everyone wanted me to stream. So, without further ado, let's get into it. We're going to be doing just a casual playthrough of it. By casual, I mean I'm not trying to get all boxes or all anything. We're just going to yellow it. Let's go. Let's see if I can do this properly, because I have a feeling I'm going to screw it up because I suck at this game. So, what Crash Bandicoot games am I good at? Well, I'm decent at CTR. I'm horrible at Crash 1. And Crash 2, Crash Warp, we're going to have to flip that coin. Ah, see? Now, the way you're meant to get the gem in this is you can't die. So that's why we're not going to care about that. We're just going to just run through and just beat this, just beat the stages as fast as we can. Not overly caring about 100% all boxes or anything like that. But if there's any nifty tricks I can show you, you know what, I'll do that. So what you're meant to do is you're meant to get your full Aku mask and run across that. And that will break all the boxes as you go past them. Okay, because my global save data got corrupted, it's only now registering that we've got Stormy Ascent unlocked. Which is weird, like I don't know why, but yeah, it is what it is. L2. So we're going to save that here. This is our new save slot. As you can see, I've beaten this game a few different ways. I beat it on the PS4, so some of this save data is fairly old. That's probably why my global save file has been corrupted. But with that being said, let's just jump right into things. I'm not making sense here. With that being said, let's just keep playing. That's what I meant to say. Now, what is my favorite Crash Bandicoot game? That's a tough one between Crash Bandicoot 2 and Crash Bandicoot 3. I played them all equally, but there was a point in time where I had Crash Bandicoot 3 and not 2. And, I basically rented it from the video store like every day without fail, so it was to the point where by the time I finished the game, Dad actually went and asked the video store guy if he can buy it, just to keep me happy. But the thing was, it was too late. I had finished everything, like 103% of everything. But nonetheless, that's how I came into contact with my copy of Crash 3. Just jump straight to the Tawna stages. I'm gonna say the easiest one is Crash 2. Favorite is probably gonna have to be Crash 3 because it just had so many different things we could play. And Crash 1 on the PS1 was insanely hard compared to how these play now. In order for you to save your game, you had to get to a bonus, or you had to beat a stage without dying. And it used the password save system too, so if you progressed and your game didn't save, you could use a password to sort of get you back where you needed to be. Bloop. Yeah, we don't care about boxes. Unless we're smashing them. Speed that up and continue. So what am I going to do here? Well, I'm going to play all the Crash Bandicoot games from start to finish, from 1, 2, and 3. We've already played Crash Team Racing. I believe I've also streamed Crash Bash with yous. I'm not sure, you'd have to check my YouTube on that one. Don't quote me. And you know that I've played Crash 4 as well, so no surprise there. Oh, it doesn't do the thing. Oh, input lag. I hate these stages because of those stupid things there. And for my own sanity, I'm glad I'm not getting all boxes because they're an absolute nightmare to do. My Digimon needs feeding. No, I'm busy. And I'm currently playing this without audio at the moment because I'm getting a bit of loop in my sound when I try and make it happen through my headset. Tawna, thank you. Now, I am playing this on the PS5. Does it make a difference? Honestly, it does. The load times on the PS4 were okay, but after anyone that's had a PS5 and played it knows that they're not acceptable anymore. You need something faster. Click. Loop. Look, what I might do is, I might go out of my way to get all the colored gems. Or at least the green one, but we'll see. How long before we unlock Coco? Alright. I don't remember a lot of these stages. Because I didn't really own Crash 1 as a kid. I played it once or twice. It was mainly my uncles and aunties that played it with me. And they wouldn't let me play after a certain point because it was their save data. But let's not kid ourselves. Anyone that played Crash 1 back in the day just put in the super password so they can access every stage. One of the longest freaking passwords in PlayStation 1 history. Whoop. Let's go. For those that were asking, I'm feeling much better after my jab. I'm just a bit of a bitch when it comes to injections. I'm a weakling. Whoop. So I was a bit crook after my Pfizer jab, and people aren't even meant to get sick after getting a Pfizer jab. But nonetheless, I got one. It was a bit sick, but I think I genuinely have some other things that I'm just getting checked out. So we're all good. I think I have an ear infection, a bit of a muffled ear. Probably come from me using my headset too much. This stage is gorgeous in the remaster. This was actually a contender for my tattoo, believe it or not, the one that I have on my leg. Elements of this level were going to be what I was going to get tattooed onto myself. But I'll show you what I ultimately ended up with when we get into Crash 2. So my leg tattoo is of the Hang 8 stage in the first warp room. But this just had such a pleasing soundtrack, even though my audio's on mute. Oh, Oh, I missed the Torn stage. Big oops. Great, but you missed all the boxes. And my tagline even says we're meant to smash some box, but as you can see, the box is smashing us. Big Poppy, let's go. Let's go, Dylan Napa. There we go, right on the butt crack. Ah, Papu Papu. He pops up in one game, disappears for the next two, then comes back in Crash Team Racing. Yes, we want Coco to join our adventure. Does Coco actually do anything? No, it's just a model change. But some people, I don't know whether it be by, like, you know, your brain tricking you to do things. Some of her animations appear slightly faster, or she has a slimmer character model, so it makes it easier for some people to navigate stages with that. I don't know. I feel that in some stages I do better with Crash and others I do better with Coco. Don't ask me how. I don't know how my brain works. One thing I forgot about Crash 1, you can spin away your bonus icons. Oop. Oop. See, we only got one because we blew up the other one with those TNT crates. Can't be dead. Oh, there we go. Guess not. Original Torna over the other Torna. What's the name? Original Torna over Crash 4 Torna. Everyone knows I'm right about that. Crash 4 Torna was just a bit edgy. I don't know. I think they just tried to make her edgy or something. I don't know. It was just odd. I think it worked for that game because it was meant to be like a revamp and redo of characters, but I don't know. Not that she's been in any games since then, so I really have no basis to complain about anything. But, yeah. Oh, Hogwild. My mate. This is his favourite stage. Now, there's a nifty little trick here where if Crash ends up dying at the end of the stage, there's a chance that the Hog can fling him into the level portal. So you actually save time by dying that way. Now I don't know whether the Hog jumping in the air is faster than him running on the ground. I can't remember, it's been that long since I got a Platinum Relic in this stage. This just had the cheekiest soundtrack though. I loved it. So yeah, if you wipe out on this guy, there's a chance you can get flung into the end of the stage and, you know, clear it faster. let me know if my audio started to desync again. Native Fortress, I hate these stages. This stage as well is one of the most annoying ones to speedrun. Sorry, not speedrun, do a time trial for. And I'm that rusty that I've forgotten how to bloody do any of these stages, so don't expect me to do any fancy relic tricks with these. I'm not that sort of player. One damn thing and then you're back at the bottom. I understand there was an Aku mask down there. Yeah, we're just gonna go there. I swear, almost every time I've played this game, I've always forgotten about that little secret area when I was looking for all boxes. No, my phone's gone off. Ugh. I keep doing the dumb shit. I'm meant to be jumping higher. Messages from people. There we go. Next issue. General reminder, stay hydrated. Water's good for you. Especially when you're inside sitting on your butt all day. Also go for walks if you're allowed to. Ah. I'm in one of those restricted local government areas, so I'm only allowed to be outside for an hour, and that's only for exercise. For those that have no idea what I'm talking about, Sydney is in one of those... Uh-oh. Shit. Sydney is in one of those bad lockdowns where you gotta do that. Certain areas are not allowed to venture outside their homes for more than an hour, and there's a curfew. That seems very, restrictive, but in the grand scheme of things, look, it's designed to minimize as much as possible the impact on emergency rooms from an influx of COVID patients. That's the whole idea behind it. It's not there to sort of as a containment measure a means for the government to, you know, lock us away and control us. It's purely so it doesn't overwhelm our health system, which is already stretched enough as it is. Oh, there's a thing there and I keep forgetting about it. Are there actions that we could have taken that would have given us a better outlook on things had we locked down sooner, etc.? Yeah, there are. But unfortunately, hindsight is 20/20, and you make the best decision based on the information presented in front of you. Nobody wants to be that person that's locked down the state. Have that target on your back, seriously. Okay, the way you overcome this is to do that. Up, 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 up. The other way around that is if you went and got the Aku... Oh, shizzle. Is if you went and got the Aku mask earlier in the stage and you kept it for that point, that's the way you get around it as well. You know, if you're having a bad time. There we go. I'll take that. I forgot to feed my Digimon. See? It's happy. There's 25 boxes. Uh-oh, SpaghettiOs. We're over onto the next island. And we're up the creek without a paddle. Let's go. Shame I don't have any of this to muscle memory. I used to. Where I'd be able to sort of blitz through this stage as fast as I could for a relic. So why do I spin when I jump? When there's nothing to be attacked while I'm... You're freaking joking me. So why do I spin when I jump when there's nothing in front of me to be attacked? Well, spin jumping actually gives you more height and distance. I don't know why, but it's a way for you to get a bit more lift out of your jumps. Very minuscule, but I know in Crash 2, it's a completely valid mechanic. It is slower though, so if you're trying to do a stage quickly, that's actually a slower method of getting around it. But I gotta admit, it feels different playing this on a PS5 controller. There's like slight vibrations whenever you make crash or spin. It's rather pleasant. It's a little quality of attention to detail. Yeah, there we go. Oh, I have to pee. I'll be back in 2 seconds. I'm sorry. VIP. Bathroom break. we're back. Alright. Continue. I just realized that I'm still on my VPN. So my connection will be a bit slow. Let me just jump off that. You idiot, Jono. What? Sorry, one second, people. Someone said that someone's responded when I haven't had anything come through my inbox yet. You need to get this out of acronym. No bloody clue. I have absolutely no idea. Ugh. Phone call, one sec.
up.
Thank you.
Are you telling me that I've been on mute this whole time? Oh my god, I've been on mute this whole time. Sorry, that was a phone call. But on top of that, I did not realize I was on mute for that entire time. I was like talking away like a freaking idiot. It's like I was talking to no one. Making commentary, talking about stuff. I don't even know at what point. Did you guys even hear that Amazon phone call that I had? Like that scam caller? You stupid son of a biscuit. Last one. Let's try not to screw this up. He lied. There we go. That's why it's important to train legs, people. I'm not sure how much more of this stream I can do. I was intending to keep going, but unfortunately, not unfortunately, I need to go for a walk. I only have an hour of walking time. Now don't load. Save. Save it, Malaka. Alright, game saved. So, I'll be going for a walk in 10 minutes. We're on the last island. Like, we're basically almost finished the darn game. I'm not even joking. It won't take me that long to finish Crash 1 if you're only doing, like, casual playthrough. Without trying to... any percent. Without trying to get 100% of everything. Thank you, Aku. He immediately loses the Aku. Didn't know about this area, did you? That's where you get the missing boxes. Slap. Spin, spin. take this as a checkpoint, thank you very much. Checkpoint. At this point here, you should have had a triple mask, I think. If you played the stage properly. Checkpoint, why not? It's always handy to have a few. Ah, screwed it up. This is reminiscent of, I think this is actually a direct clone of one of the challenges in Crash 4. The flashback tapes, that's it. Could be wrong. I have been wrong before. Contrary to popular belief, I am a bit of an idiot. The hard thing, you can't see above you. And you know what? Stuff it. We're just gonna have to do this without dying. There we go. Stage complete. Yeah, I know, I missed a lot of boxes, mate. Give me a break. 58. Damn. Was it heavy machinery that gave you lives, or was it? Let's just jump into it. If we don't like it, we'll exit the stage. I'm pretty sure one of the stages you jump into, it's not this one. One of the stages you jump into lets you just skip all of it, and we're gonna do that. Cortex power. This is a really painful stage to do. And sometimes you just have to hit the cycles correctly. And you get punished for taking the wrong route as well. I'll take that checkpoint. Try this side. I gotta admit, the sludge effects that they did on this game, beautiful. Pfft. Ah, nose is itchy. I'll take a checkpoint, please. No, stuff it. I'll take this instead. Generator room. Creepy stage. So these screens looked a lot more creepy in the OG, because it's just Cortex's face, his low-res face phasing in and out. Oops. Damn it. Even though down there is visible, it's not actually a walkable platform, so you will die if you attempt to jump down there. Oh, damn it. Oh, I've gone the wrong way. Okay. I was trying to commit Sudoku there. Ah, oh, you can't get that checkpoint. You cheeky buggers. Now, call me crazy, but aren't those things meant to have lightning coming off them? Nine boxes. Continue. Alright, how many stages do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 stages. Alright. I'm going to end the stream there. Next stream, we're going to finish this game and also do Stormy Ascent and do all the secret stages. It's going to be a royal pain in the butt, but I believe in us. And look, we've been going for an hour and 25, so thank you all for joining. I'll catch you next time. It'll probably be tomorrow or tonight, I don't know. But till then,